All right. In class, I promised that I would show you the simplest server ever, so I've got the code for it, and let's dig in and see exactly what that looks like. So if we look here, this is the Python code to write a server. And really, this is it. And you don't even need all of this. Most of this code is just to do stuff. So let's dig in and talk about that. So what is a server? A server is software that listens on a socket, and we'll talk in just a second about what a socket means. It listens on a socket, hears some data, does some stuff. And this is the server software. So here I've got the server, and this is using a built-in Python package called socket server. So you can see I'm importing that and then doing some stuff with that to make it. And the bulk of the code right here to make the server is in this handle function. So obviously this stream request handler has a whole bunch of built-in stuff to handle the network connection and responding and doing all of those things that the server needs to do. But if you write this code, create a handle function, all of this right here is totally unnecessary. You can have a server that doesn't actually do anything. This code here is so that the server does something. And what does that server do? It listens, it hears data, receives data. So it's receiving a request, getting the data from that, stripping it. You know what the Python strip function does? It strips off the white space and then stores that in this little variable called data and prints out some logging information, including the IP address that things are being sent from and the data itself. And then it sends the data back in uppercase. So it converts it to uppercase and sends it back. Really, again, all of this, you can have it do whatever you want. This is just to demonstrate the simplest possible server that you can see, printing out the data that it got, returning it all uppercaseified. And then we've got this function down here that creates that socket that I was talking about. So it creates a TCP server using the transmission control protocol, and we'll get into what that means later on. You have to specify an IP address and a port. And the IP address and the port together make the socket. And in the case of 0.0.0.0, that's a bit of a special IP address. And we'll get into more details about what IP addresses are and what they look like and what special addresses there might be and what they mean. But the important thing here is that 0.0.0.0 is a special IP address that means any IP address on this machine. So when I run this server, what it means is that any IP address that this machine thinks it owns, if a message comes in on that IP address, it will respond. So if I were to put 127.0.0.1 here, it will only listen on the local host, the local interface, and you wouldn't be able to send requests from outside this machine in. But if I do 0.0.0.0, any machine on any network would be able to send to the public IP address here. Again, don't worry too much about what exactly that means. When we get into IP addressing and routing and all that stuff, that will make more sense. And then I set it up on port 9090. I give it this class that I created, the TCP request handler, that tells it what to do when the server is running, and then I tell it to serve forever. If I didn't tell it to serve forever, it would get one request and then stop. I want it to serve forever because I want it to keep going. So if I go down here to the bottom to my little built-in terminal, and I run the server, it's running, nothing's happening, as you can tell, because there's no messages. So let me split up this terminal, make a new one. So you can see on the left-hand side here, the TCP server is running. And if I, on the right-hand side, run python client.py, we sent a message. And let's go look at client.py. What is client.py? It's saying, I want to open a socket using stream protocols. And again, all this stuff will make more sense. Connect to the host and the port. And the host is localhost. The port is 9090. Send some data. And the data, well, sorry. This is the data that's being sent. This is the data that's being received. Here it's being printed out. And that is why we have sup world. So we send lowercase sup world, and you see we receive uppercase sup world. So the protocol is working, and if I change this to say howdy doody, or, well, yeah, let's send howdy doody. Save. Send. Boom. And you'll see the server is doing what it says. It's saying, I got a request, such and such IP address. Here's the data that I received. And then after it prints out the data that's received, it sends it back as uppercase. So that is the simplest server that you could possibly have. Python handles most of the complicated network stuff. And you have now, if you copy this code or write this code or edit this to do whatever you want it to do, you will have written a server that can respond to requests. And that is exactly what server software does.